We consider this question a flaw method of reasoning question, or otherwise known as a descriptive weakening question. So sometimes I'll say those two phrases interchangeably because they mean the same thing. What we're going to do is just look at the questions then. The reasoning in this argument, there's reasoning in this argument, is vulnerable to criticism on the ground that the argument has done something, right? You see, all these answer choices start with verbs because we're being asked to describe where the argument is weak. That's why I call it descriptive weakening, or otherwise known as a flaw question. But so the stimulus reads, many corporations have begun decorating their halls with motivational posters in hopes of boosting their employees' motivation to work productively. All right, so imagine you are, the boss, and you have a company, and you have workers, and you plaster your hallway with those, I think you guys have all seen motivational posters, right? Beautiful pictures of a sunset. A quote from Thomas Edison at the bottom says, genius is 99%, 1% inspiration, and 99% perspiration, right? And then hopefully your employee sees it and is like, oh, I better go perspire and be productive. But anyway, so however, almost all employees, see, this word however here renders all this stuff context, and this is a lesson from our grammar lessons, but what's going on is the author is saying, okay, blah, 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 however, now pay attention, now I want to make my point, now I want to make my argument. However, almost all employees at these corporations are already motivated to work productively, so renders this part premise, and that this part that follows the conclusion. So here's our argument, and then we already know that there's some vulnerability, which means the support here going from this premise to this conclusion is not very strong, it's sort of weak. So what? So these corporations use motivational posters, unlikely to achieve its intended purpose. Now, this is grammatically what we call a referential phrase. What's the intended purpose? Well, they talked about it earlier in the hopes of, right? You see, the hopes of boosting their employees' motivation to work productively. So the argument is that, look, these people are already working motivated to work productively, so these posters are not going to motivate them to work even more productively. But do you sort of see already why this argument is bad? This premise doesn't support this conclusion because it's failing to make a distinction between relative and absolute. I suppose that's one way you can think about it. In absolute sense, these employees are motivated, sure. But in a relative sense, can people that are motivated be motivated even more? Yeah, of course, right? Like, you're running. Can you run? You're running at like 5 miles an hour. Can you run faster? Yeah, probably. Right, so just because they're already motivated doesn't mean they can't be. You can't boost their motivation. That's what we're trying to do. But whatever level you are, boost it. So that's what makes, this is called anticipating the correct answer choice. And you have to be able to, at some point, you have to be able to get to do this, especially for something like question number 4. Because in the first 10 questions on any LR set, there's going to be like 6 or 7 of them, or even more, that are really easy. You just have to be able to, sort of fly through it. So let's consider the answer choices. Fails to consider whether corporations that do not currently use motivational posters increase their employees' motivation to work productively if they began using the posters. But I would, on this actual question, when the clock's ticking, I would just eliminate it and move right on. But now, sort of since we're reviewing, let's actually articulate the reason why A is wrong. It's because we are precisely considering companies that don't already use motivational posters, right? We're talking about companies that, should I start using them? So it's not failing to consider these companies. Right, corporations that do not currently use posters. That's precisely what we're talking about, right? These companies have begun decorating. So previously they weren't, now they are. B says, takes for granted with respect to the employees' motivation to work productively, the corporations decorate their halls are representative. We don't care if they're representative of corporations in general. There's no sort of, you can imagine an argument that makes the mistake that B does, right? We talk about a subset of companies A, B, C. And then from what happens in companies A, B, C, we try to generalize to say, oh, well then therefore, because it happened in companies A, B, C, it must be true for all companies. Then you have to consider whether A, B, C is representative of, all the companies. C says, fails to consider that even if posters do not have one particular benefit, they may have similar effects that are equally beneficial, but we don't care. I mean, sure, they might be pleasant to look at. Your employees might just be happy to look at them. But that's great, but you see, that has nothing to do with where our argument is weak. Our argument is weak precisely for the mistake that we already talked about, right? So this is just not something, you want to distinguish answer choice A from C because A is wrong because it fails to describe the argument accurately. It's just not descriptive. C does describe the argument because we have failed to consider this thing, but it's just, that's not, the fact that the argument failed to consider this thing is not where the argument's weak. That's what makes C incorrect. So in our descriptive weakening lessons, we call it a two-step test. Step one is you got to be descriptively accurate, which A doesn't pass, but C passes. But step two, once you're descriptively accurate, you got to make sure you're describing the weakness of the argument. That's where C doesn't pass the test. D says, the argument does not adequately address the possibility that productivity is strongly affected by other factors. Yeah, I mean, okay, see, D is very similar to C. It's accurate in the sense of descriptively accurate. We don't consider the possibility that other things also affect productivity, but we don't need to consider it, right? Because the argument is just talking about this premise to this conclusion. And E is the correct answer choice. Fails to consider that even if employees are already motivated to work productively, motivational posters may increase that motivation. So there you go. Very easy. I think it's a very easy question. The wrong answer choices here are meant to illustrate lessons that are applicable to other questions that are, way more difficult than this one.